गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर लर्न सो द सीआरटी कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द सीआरटी एंड फीचर्स ऑफ द सीआरटी एंड आल्सो वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सिंपल सीआरओ सो हाउ द पावर सप्लाई इज कनेक्टेड टू सीआरओ. So what are the different power supply sources are usual to operate the CRT and the different circuit diagrams of amplifiers and sweep generator circuits are discussed. So, and also we are seeing what are the main elements of the CRT, different anodes, focusing anode, accelerating anodes, cathode, control grid. Okay, in the CRT we are observed in the CRT, and today we'll see so what are the other components of the oscilloscope, so such as so the other components of the CRO after the CRT is vertical amplifier section, horizontal amplifier section, vertical amplifier sections, horizontal deflecting system or a horizontal amplification system. So like this we have another two types of these systems. So how these systems are will constructed, so what are the main components are presented, so that we will see in today's class. So what are the different amplifiers or circuitry are used for deflecting the vertical and horizontal deflection system, Hutton deflection plates, so that we will see. So goes to, so the first one is vertical amplifier. So vertical amplifier, so it is the first block in the oscilloscope. So for this vertical amplifier we will give the input, so the test signal, so the measuring signal, which one is to be required to measure the voltage or frequency or current. So that is applied to the first one is first we apply to the vertical amplifier. So here we will design the amplifier in such a way that so the sensitivity and bandwidth, the product of the sensitivity and bandwidth should be constant, okay, and it should be higher value, okay. So because the sensitivity is nothing but here it is gain, okay, and frequency bandwidth, so bandwidth also should be high and the gain should be high, okay, in such a way that we can design the vertical amplifier. So whenever we can design the amplifier with high frequency bandwidth, so we can analyze the signals having the frequency range from lower to higher values, okay. So here this is the gain bandwidth product is constant, so if you consider the bandwidth, so that is nothing but the frequency bandwidth and gain, the product of these two is a constant. If you want to get the better gain or greater amount of the gain, so you have to decrease the bandwidth, so any one should be maximum and another should be decreased, but we should design a oscilloscope such that it should be constant and able to better sensitivity as well as the better frequency bandwidth in such a way that we can design the amplifiers, okay. Some oscilloscopes give two alternatives, so switching to wide bandwidth position and switching to high sensitivity position. In some oscilloscopes we can also able to use only for bandwidth, high bandwidth, or we can use only for high sensitivity. So in some cases, the frequency is not considered. Okay, so we consider only the sensitivity is the main importance. So in such situation, we have to go for the high sensitivity. In some cases, the sensitivity is not a matter, we will not consider. So in such situation, we have to choose a high bandwidth of the frequency. Okay, like that we can adjust the frequency as well bandwidth as well as the sensitivity. So this diagram shows the block diagram of a vertical amplifier. So vertical amplifier. So in this vertical amplifier, here we have an input attenuator. So input attenuator. So attenuator, it will reduces the high values are applied. So those high values will be reduces in terms of the voltage. Okay. So the shape of the signal does not change. Okay. And that signal is applied to the FET input amplifier. FET input amplifier. So here, this FET input amplifier will act as a buffer amplifier. Like it will act as a buffer amplifier. And so after that, FET input amplifier will apply to the main amplifier. So main amplifier, here in this main amplifier stage, we have we will use the push-pull amplifiers. So by this push-pull amplifiers, we can get the equal voltage, but in antiphase. So we will get the two output signals. So which are in opposite. Suppose this is the two output signals, which are antiphase. Those are in antiphase, and those are applied to the vertical deflection plates. Okay. So after the signal is attenuated, the input signal is attenuated. So it is given to FET input amplifier. So in the first stage we have, so in the FET input amplifier we have, so FET source follower. So this is a FET source follower. It will because it will be acts as FET source follower. So it will be separates the input side and the output side. So the remaining circuits will be so because it will offers high input impedance, so that's why it should be isolated. If any loading effects are occurred, so those will be reduced. So that's why we can use the FET source follower. So the output of the source follower is connected to a BJT emitter follower. So this is a phase inverter. The second one is the phase inverter. This phase inverter will produce the two output signals. So these are like a push-pull amplifier. Okay. So this is also why we are using here. It means so the output of the FET amplifier is the output of the FET amplifier is, so it is having a low output impedance. To match this low output impedance, we are connected a BJT emitter follower. So with this we can generate the two output signals with antiphase. So here we are using a phase inverter. Here we are using a phase inverter. Okay, so from that it will be given to driver amplifier. So to drive the deflection plates, to move the deflection plates, how much voltage is required, that should be amplified by the driver amplifier. Should perform the amplification process of the applied input from the phase inverter, and that is applied through the output amplifier. So here also it will be amplified. So here the main purpose is to amplify the signal. That signal should be drive the horizontal. Here it is vertical deflection plates. So it will should drive the vertical deflection plates. So in such a way that so it will be produces the voltages. So here it will generate the voltages with the antiphase. Okay, there is no there is no ground. Okay, these two signals are equal voltages, but if this is positive and this is negative. Okay, so let me see. So the vertical amplifier consists of several stages with fixed overall sensitivity or gain expressed in volts per division. So generally we will express in terms of volts per division. Sensitivity will be expressed in volts per division. Okay. So here the advantage of fixed gain is that amplifier can be more easily designed. So here we will consider the gain should be constant or fixed. We can make it as fixed. So by that we can easily design the amplifier. Okay, and the vertical amplifier is kept within its signal and handling capability by proper selection of the input attenuator switch. So by using attenuator switch, we can select the signal. Okay, so within the amplifier range. So in the first element of the preamplifier is the input stage. Okay, so often it is consists of a FET source follower, so whose high input impedance isolates the amplifier from the attenuator. So the main purpose of the follower is, whether it is BJT or FET source follower, is to provide the isolation. So if there is any high currents are driving by the source or load, so it does not create any problem on the actual circuit. So like that, it will be provides isolation by high input impedance. Due to the high input impedance, it provides the isolation, separation of the signal. But physically it is connected. But if there is any sudden loads or variations are occurred, so that will be separated. So the impact of the load variations does not fall on the actual circuitry. So in such a way that it will be separates. Okay, this FET input stage is followed by BJT emitter follower. So this is the FET FET emit source follower. Okay, and this is the BJT emitter follower. Okay, so after the FET output, it will be given to a BJT emitter follower. So to match the medium impedance of FET output with the low impedance input of the phase inverter. So to match the FET source follower having low output impedance. Okay, so that to match that low output impedance, we are connected a BJT. This is BJT emitter follower. Okay, BJT emitter follower. And the phase inverter provides two anti-phase output signals. So here it will provide two anti-phase output signals. Okay, so output signals which are required to operate the push-pull output amplifier. So that is applied to the driver amplifier. So driver amplifier is nothing but it is a push-pull amplifier. Here the push-pull output stage delivers equal signal voltages of opposite polarity to the vertical plates of CRT. So that push-pull signals are applies to the vertical plates to drive the vertical plates of the CRT. The advantages of push-pull operation CRO are similar to those obtained push-pull operation other applications. That is the main advantage. Why we are using the push-pull operation is, so it is having better hum voltage cancellation. So hum voltage cancellation from source or power supply. So there is some like hum type of the signals will come. So it will produce a type of these signals, that is a hum voltage. So those signals will be cancelled out, because so it will generate the two antiphase voltages. And even harmonic signals also suppressed. Even harmonic, so here we have harmonic signals. So even harmonic signals also suppressed by using the push-pull operation. And the especially for second harmonic signal is cancelled out. And a greater power output per tube as a result of even harmonic cancellation will be obtained. We can obtain the greater output power per tube. Here the per tube means, so by for the given tube, so CRT tube, we can get the higher output power. So because we are cancellating the second harmonic power, harmonic component, by that we can get the some power savings. Okay. And in addition, a number of defocusing and nonlinear effects are reduced. So some, if there is any nonlinear effects are there, those will be reduced because of neither plate is at ground potential. So here we can consider that among the two plates, no plate is grounded. Only we are providing two equal and opposite polarity signals, voltage signals. These are the advantages of using the push-pull amplifiers. So that is the vertical amplifier section. So coming to the next one is horizontal deflecting system. So in the horizontal deflecting system, we have the main block which is considered for the horizontal deflection system is the sweep generator or time-based generator. Sweep generator or time-based generator. Horizontal amplifier section, we have horizontal amplifier section and trigger section. So in the horizontal deflection system, we have trigger generator, time-based generator or sweep generator. And the third one is horizontal amplifier section. And the output of the horizontal amplifier is given to horizontal deflection plates. Okay. Like this, we have three sections in the horizontal deflecting system. Okay. So in that, the main and important consideration of the for the generating horizontal or x-axis of the waveform is the time-based generator. The horizontal deflecting system consists of a time-based generator and an output amplifier. Okay. It mainly consists of a time-based generator and an output amplifier. So here the output amplifier is nothing but the horizontal amplifier. So here we will see how the time-based generator will be operates, or how the sweep generation was occurred by using the an UJT. So UJT is nothing but uni junction transistor. So here in this case we have this is the UJT. Okay. And it is having an emitter base 1, base 2. I think you may be studied in previous year classes. This is B2. It is having emitter base 1, base 2. This is the base 2, this is the base 1, and this is the emitter. So suppose initially, isn't that here we are applied a voltage of VBB. Okay, and by the application of the VBB voltage, what happens? The current will be flows through the RT and CT. Okay, the voltage will be applied VBB. So due to that, the capacitor will be charges. The capacitor will be, see here, The right side of the diagram shows the output waveform. Okay, so the capacitor will be charges up to some peak value. Okay, so after that the UJT will be triggers on. So after reaching the peak value of the voltage across the capacitor CT, the UJT will be triggers on. So it means it is on. How it will be on is the base B1 and emitter will be formed as a forward bias diode. So after reaching a certain value of peak value, so it forms as the emitter and the base one junction will be formed as a diode, and that should be in forward bias. So that's why the capacitor will be discharges in this manner. The capacitor will be discharges sharply. Okay, so that's why after reaching the VP value, peak value, some peak value, it will be discharges sharply. And after reaching the minimum value of the voltage across the capacitor, the UJT will be turned off. UJT will be turned off. So after that, again, the capacitor will be charges. So that is the charging point. Again, the capacitor will be charges to the peak value. And after reaching the peak value, the UJT will be turned on, and due to that, the capacitor will be again discharges sharply. So like this, we have charging and discharging of the capacitor will be occurred by the UJT. So by that, we can produce the sawtooth sweep generation output voltage. So here we have already we have seen sweep generator circuit in the sequence generators. The second unit of the sequence generator. So here we have a sweep period. This is the sweep period. Sweep period, and this is the retrace period. Okay. So discharging period after reaching the peak value, the capacitor will be discharges. The discharging time period will be considered as the retrace period, and the from minimum value to some peak value, it will be charges. So the time period, the time required for that reaching from V minimum to emitter voltage, here it is emitter voltage, minimum value to the peak value will be considered as the sweep period. Okay. So like this, so we can produce the sweep voltage by using sweep generator, by using the UJT. So here the main thing is after reaching the voltage across the CT capacitor to a peak value, the emitter and base one of the UJT will form as a forward biased diode. So when the forward biased diode is formed, then it will be the capacitor will be discharges through this path. The capacitor after reaching the some peak value. So the capacitor will be discharges through this way, in this way. Again, the voltage after reaching the minimum value of voltage across VE, the voltage across the CT or the capacitor voltage, or the voltage across the voltage of VE, the potential of the emitter. Okay, so the voltage across emitter will be reaches to a minimum value. This UJT will be turned off, and when it is turned off, the voltage from the source is coming to the CT, and the capacitor is again charges. Like this, charging and discharging cycle will be continuous until the source is available, until the source is provided. Okay, so that like that we can get this sawtooth waveform. Or sweep, we can call it as sweep voltage. So if the discharging period is very low, if the discharging period, that is retrace period, is very small, then this becomes a perfect sawtooth waveform. See here, suppose this is the charging period and this is the discharging period. The discharging fluid is very sharp. So rapidly discharges, then the redress speed is very small. So then we can get the perfect sawtooth grain bore. So sawtooth means, so sawtooth, so rampam. Rampam pallu ela untayo. So rampam pallu ela untay kada, I think all of you know that. So that's why the name came as sawtooth waveform. So like this we can generate the sawtooth waveform from the time base generator. Okay. So here it is given that explanation what our drivers describe here. So continuous sweep CRO using UJT shown in the figure. The UJT is used to produce the sweep voltage. When the power is first applied, the UJT is off and CT this is charges exponentially through RT. So through the RT resistance, through R resistance it will be charges. Okay, so the UJT emitter voltage VE rises towards VBB, and when VE reaches the peak voltage VP as shown in figure 1, the emitter to base 1 diode becomes forward bias and UJT is triggers on. The UJT is triggers on. This provides a low resistance discharge path and the capacitor discharges rapidly. The capacitor recharges and cycle repeats. So when the emitter voltage VE reaches a minimum value rapidly and the UJT goes off, to improve the sweep linearity, two separate voltage supplies are used. So here to improve the sweep linearity, so here we are going to use the two separate voltages. So one is high voltage and another is the low voltage. Low voltage supply for the UJT and high voltage supply for the RTCT circuit. So here in this circuit we can use two supplies. One supply for the UJT, operation of the UJT, and we can make separation of this one. So we can disconnect this one, and here we will apply a voltage of low voltage, and here we will apply the high voltage. So by that we can get the better sensitivity of the output voltage. Okay, high voltage will be applied here. So why we have to connect two separate voltages means, suppose we are using a VBB voltage here. So this voltage when charging the CT, so then also it should be provides some current through this operation of the UJT. So in such situation, the output waveform may not be obtained correctly. So there is some deviations. Suppose when the UJT is on, so it may be having some variations like this. It does not get the smooth waveform. There is some variations because the same voltage is applying for the charging and discharging and also for the operation of the UJT. So in such situation, we will get some variations in the output voltage. So to avoid such situations, so we are using two separate voltages. We are going to use the two separate voltages, one for the operation of this UJT and another for the charging of this CT capacitor. So we can also adjust the frequency by using the RT. So the frequency range, we can also, the frequency of the signal can be adjusted by using the R. This is RT. Okay. So suppose by changing the resistance, so the capacity will be charges differently. Suppose the resistance is decreases, isn't that? The resistance is decreased, then what happens? The current, more amount of the current will be flows through this, and the capacitor will be charges very fastly. Quickly charges. And when it will reaches the peak value, so the UJT will be turned on, triggered on, and due to that, there is a low discharge path will be occurs, and due to that the capacitor will be discharges rapidly. Okay, so again, the when the capacitor voltage will be reaches to a minimum value, that is nothing but the VE or VE minimum. So again, the UJT will be triggered off, and due to that, again, the capacitor will be charges. Because of the having low resistance value, the current will be, high current will be passes, and due to that, the capacitor will be charges quickly. And after reaching the peak value, the UJT will be turned on, that is called as triggered on, and due to that, the capacitor will be discharges quickly. And like that, again, reaches the minimum value. So again, it will be charges, discharges, charges, discharges. So like this, we can get the sawtooth waveform, and we can adjust the frequency. Suppose if you increase the value of RT, so resistance value is increased. So then what happens? We'll get the small amount of the current. So due to that, the capacitor will be charges. Charging of the capacitor will be takes long time. And discharge, okay, depends upon the path of the discharge path of the emitter and base one. Okay. And again, to charge, it will takes time. So like that, we can have the time period is different. So time period different means we can adjust the frequency by using the RT. So for varying the frequency of the time period, we can adjust the RT. Okay. So like this, we can vary the frequency by using the resistance and by using separate two voltages, we can produce the pure output waveform. Okay. So like this, we can generate the sawtooth waveform, and this sawtooth waveform will be applied for the argent deflection plates through argent deflection amplifier, that is the output amplifier, argent output amplifier. So the same what we explained is explained in this one. So there are okay. So RT is used for continuous control of frequency in range, and CT is varied or changed in steps for range changing. Okay, so range changing also you can apply. You can adjust the CT. CT is varied or changed in steps for range changing. So. Some of the frequency range, within the frequency range, we can fine tune by using RT. So suppose we have to change the frequency range from 1 to 100 hertz, to 100 to 200 hertz, 200 to 1000 hertz. Like this, we have different frequency ranges. So by using the CT, capacitance varying the CT, we can shift from one range to another range. So that can be performed by varying the CT. And in the given frequency band or frequency range, suppose we have to change the frequency range from 200 to 500, that is done by CT. In the 200 to 500, I have to adjust the frequency at 300 hertz. So that will be done by using the RT, resistance. So these are sometimes called as timer resistor and the timing capacitor. So the RT is called as timing resistor, and CT is called as a timing capacitor. So here we have another signal, that is a synchronous pulse enables the sweep frequency to be exactly equal to the input signal frequency, so that signal is locked on the screen and does not drift. Suppose, so in some cases, you can apply the synchronous pulse. So synchronous pulse you can apply at, see here, so at this B2 of the UJT, we will apply synchronous pulse input. Synchronous pulse input. By the application of this synchronous pulse input, we can lock the input frequency with the, so we can lock the signal with the sweep frequency. Sweep frequency with the input signal frequency. So we can match the input signal frequency and the sweep frequency. Okay. So that will be performed by applying synchronous pulse, external synchronous input we can apply. Okay. So with this, today we are discussed about so the vertical amplifier section, that is the vertical amplifier, what are how the amplifier voltage will be generated, so what are the main components present in the vertical amplifier, and the horizontal diffraction system. So in the horizontal diffraction system, we are discussed about the sweep generator, continuous sweep generation. So if you have any doubts or clarifications, you can. You can ask. Who is this Pawan Kalyan? Pawan Kalyan Srinivas Rally. What is your roll numbers? I think you are typing chart for roll number. Okay. So with this discussion, we are finishing.